on, dig in and play. Get down and play, Harper.
Nike presents UMass Basketball with John Calipari. Tonight's show is brought to you by Mass Lottery, Friendly Restaurants, 9X Yellow Pages, UMass Court Club, and UMass Alumni Association, Spalding Sports Worldwide, Wally Computer Associates, your New England Ford dealers, and by all Bob stores. And now, Coach John Calipari and Rich Tedemer.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Bob Rumbold, and welcome to tonight's Nike UMass basketball show with John Calipari. Look left, look right. Where's Coach Cal? Where's Rich? Well, first of all, Coach Cal is out in Western New York, where this afternoon the UMass Minutemen had a bonny good time against the Bonnies of St. Bonaventure. A nice little 93-78 victory there. We'll look at that momentarily. And speaking of Rich, well, Rich is out in Pasadena checking out Super Bowl XXVII. So both pretty happy folks, but they'll be back next week. In fact, they'll be back later on in the show to give you a nice little look at the new Mullins Center, which will open Thursday night when West Virginia comes to town in another very important Atlantic 10 contest. All right, let's talk about the other building, the cage. That's right, the Curry Hicks cage. Friday night was the final rage in the cage for the UMass men's basketball team. A nice little 84-74 victory over poetic, ironic, whatever you call it, the Ragin' Cajuns of southwestern Louisiana. Run-and-gun team and a fun team. And what was it was a really fun night for everybody. I got to see the second half, got up there after the show, and it was just a lot of fun, a lot of good action, and one very special night. With the story of that special night, Steve Rule here.
One last rage in the cage. Some 5,000 fans painted their faces, their bodies, wore their souvenir t-shirts, and helped the home team win one last time in the storied building known as the Curry Hicks Cage. The familiar faces were present, including former UMass coach Jack Lehman from the Julius Erving days. Minutes after midnight, off the opening tip-off, Derek Kellogg set the UMass Minutemen off right against southwestern Louisiana. And we don't think Ragin' Cajun coach Marty Fletcher is saying, "Wow, I could have had a V8. However, the Ragin' Cajuns should be more appropriately called the Running Cajuns, forcing UMass to play up-tempo.
We like to try to change defenses, and I thought we did a good job of creating some turnovers. But
UMass wasn't about to lose this one. Harper Williams gives UMass a 13-point lead midway second half. Dana Dingle made sure he was part of history scoring in the final cage game, and Lou Rowe sealed it with a jam.
This is, you know, a running team, and that's something that, you know, we wanted to do also. But, you know, we just guarded them a little bit more than they guarded us, and we were able to come up with the victory.
Fearing vandalism to the building, the game was called with 3 seconds still on the clock, and Coach John Calipari pleading for peace.
The cage is going to be here another 60 years. Don't screw it up and mess up this floor, the backboard, the rims, or anything. You've been great all year. Classy fans, the best in the country. Don't screw it up.
The crowd still swarmed the floor to say one last goodbye to men's basketball at the cage.
Do you miss this place?
Yeah, probably, you know, probably the loudness, but, you know, we had to see how the Mullins cage is.
In January of 1932, UMass wins its first game at the cage. In January of 1993, UMass wins the last game at the cage, 84-74.
Thank you, Steve. Yes, he did make it back from that one. Now let's get to the second game this week against the Bonnies of St. Bonaventure. A nice little victory. Let's go to Olean, New York, where Coach Cal doesn't look as nervous as he usually does. Doesn't have to. Tony Barbie, the three. Tony with 14. They got off to a great start. Jerome Malloy, bang, three-pointer there, 13 for Jerome. They build a 10-2 lead. And
Kellogg from 15, left alone.
These guys? They can't. Luro, what a great game. Lewis, seven rebounds, a career-high 21 points, and a three-point play right here. The leading scorer in the game, however, Harry Moore, 31. Nice drive to the basket right there. The leading assist man, you got it, Derek Kellogg. Nice pass inside to Harper Williams. Harper with 12 points and 7 rebounds. And from there, UMass keeps building on the lead. 12 points in the first half for Mike Williams, 14 overall. They lead by as many as 27. They lead by 22 at the half. That's the kind of day it was for the Bonnies. Moore missing the jam right there. Second half, all UMass. Luro down the lane, the three-point play right there. Yes, and it counts. And also a solid game for the freshman, Dana Dingle. Watch him coming up here. He's going to steal it. 14 points, six rebounds. UMass rolls, 93-78. The final. Nice. All right, let's move on. Next up, our friendlies player of the week. Could have been Dana Dingle, could have been Harper Williams, but it's this man, Lou Rowe. That's right, Lou with 21 points and 7 rebounds in this one. Friday night, Lou with 15 points and 11 rebounds. So, Lou Rowe, this week, friendly player of the week. Watch Lou inside. Oh, nice job right there. So, Lou Rowe, the winner of the friendly player of the week. And congratulations to Lewis. Again, 15-11. 21-7. He's averaging 14.5 points and 8.4 rebounds. A great job by Lou Rowe. All right, coming up, we have more with Rich and Coach Cal showing you the cage. And, of course, this week's Minute with the Minutemen, Kennard Robinson. Have a good time, everybody.
Game for the Minutemen is, of course, the grand opening of the William D. Mullins Memorial and Convocation Center against West Virginia. And welcome back to the Mullins Center. Here's John Calipari sitting in his own coach's office. Coach, this is an incredible place.
Well, the whole setup is incredible, from the stands to the seats, no bleachered seats, to the locker rooms, to the VIP rooms, to our office suites, which are outstanding. I mean, as good as any in the country.
The finishing touches are still being put on, but it really is a state-of-the-art facility.
I haven't been in many buildings that are nicer than this, and I think as a resident of the state of Massachusetts, I think we all should be proud of this building.
We're going to take you around the Mullins Center a little bit later on in the show, but first, here's Bob Rumbold with another Minute with the Minutemen.
When Harper Williams went down with a broken hand, one of the guys that did a great job of filling the void in the middle was Kennard Robinson. The senior out of Long Island Lutheran High in New York's been a defensive specialist. Plus, he's put a few points on the board as well. Of course, being a student athlete can be tough, but Kennard, who's a real estate management major, is one of those student athletes who found that the classroom was easier than the court.
When I first came here and, you know, with the schoolwork and stuff like that, I knew I could handle the schoolwork. That was no problem. I didn't know how basketball was going to be for me. It took me quite a while to get back into the groove and stuff like that. But Coach Cal talked to me.
But by the end of his sophomore season, he was getting in the groove. And then last year, he really came on and saw some quality minutes.
I was always waiting for the opportunity to play and stuff like that. I mean, I played a lot last year, not as much, but I mean, when I came in, I played hard.
As we said, Kennard really responded when Harper went down, and as Robinson says, he got by with a little help from his friends.
I have everybody backing me this year, you know, and especially Harper. Harper's talking to me a lot. Tony's talking to me, you know, and I mean, you know, everybody's just like, you know, just go out there and play as hard as you can, and that's what I'm doing.
As you can probably see, Kennard, who hopes to own his own real estate agency someday, really has enjoyed his time at UMass, both on and off the court.
It's been a great experience. It's nothing like college life, so come to college.
Agreed, Kennard. With the Minutemen, I'm Bob Rumbold.
Thank you, Bob. Now let's talk about this facility, John. Hoops Weiss was here recently, Dick Hoops Weiss from the Daily News of Philadelphia, and he was really emphatic about the fact that this was a great facility for basketball, not only for New England, but for UMass basketball.
Well, he's been in many pro arenas. I've been in many pro arenas. I haven't seen any nicer. The arena in Phoenix, I hear, is like the marquee facility. But as far as a college arena, I don't see any better. I mean, you're talking about great viewing of for fans, the office complex, the locker room complex, the VIP suites. We even have boxes down on the floor. So I'm impressed and very, very much excited about moving over here.
For his own expert opinion, here's Dick Hoops Weiss.
this will be the finest arena of its kind in New England. It's the type of arena that will attract a lot of television interest. It's a type of arena that will attract a lot of people to come back to their roots and attend games there. They already have, if they've got a base of 5,000 season tickets, I would suggest that the people out there would do well to look into purchasing them now and getting in on the ground floor, because if this program continues along the way, I think it's going to continue. And if Camby is the player that I think he is, I honestly believe that it's going to be very difficult to get a ticket for a home game within the next 2 or 3 years.
He should know, because Dick Hoops Weiss has probably been in more basketball arenas around the country than just about anyone. John doesn't want to leave his office right now, but we will, because he's got some more things to do here. We want to go down onto the floor and see what this Mullins Center looks like from courtside. So we'll do that coming up next with a walk around the Mullins Center. Stay with us. Welcome back to the Mullins Center. John Calipari sitting here in row 5. You're not going to spend much time in this row, but this is a really neat place to see a game, hockey or basketball.
Well, it's just the spacing of the seats. They're comfortable. You're right on the floor. And this isn't a mid-court seat. It'll be like a sideline seat, but it's still a great seat.
The place is set up for hockey right now before we speak. Obviously, we'll be playing basketball on February the 4th, but what can the people expect to see here? It's so much different than the cage.
The main thing you'll see is a parquet floor. They came out with the parquet floor with UMass script on it, not a whole lot of other things on the floor, and then that looks terrific. I think what you'll see is a basketball arena. It's in a mode right now where it's ice skating and hockey. In a basketball arena, it's a little bit different when it's in that mode.
Before we move too much further, let's take a look at the man this place is named after, William D. Mullins. Ludlow native William D. Mullins served in the state legislature for the last 10 years of his life. The vice chairman of the House Ways and Means Committee was a determined campaigner for a new sports facility on the Amherst campus of the University of Massachusetts. Bill Mullins died in 1986, but his memory lives on thanks to the arena that bears his name, the William D. Mullins Athletic and Convocation Center. Joining us now is Lee Eskelson, who's the executive director of the Mullins Center. And Lee, it's got to be a real honor to be in charge of a building that's just so impressive.
Oh, it's fantastic. This is a state-of-the-art facility, and we're just happy to be here and be a part of it.
You know, Lee and I had a meeting when we first met, and I said to him, Lee, when this building is in a basketball mode, it's got to look like just a basketball arena. And I said, when we played in the Great Alaska Shootout, I never knew that they played hockey in that facility until someone told me. And Lee's comment was,
this is also an Ogden facility.
And I said, good.
The facility in Alaska, the Sullivan Arena, is run also by Ogden. It's one of the first Ogden buildings. And this building even goes beyond that. The nice thing about this facility is it's so flexible that when we're in a basketball mode, people will think it was built just for basketball. When it's in a hockey mode, it'll look like it's built just for hockey. And when we're doing a concert or center stage show in here, they'll think it was built just for that concert. So that's the nice thing about it. The university in the state of Massachusetts did a tremendous job in building a very flexible building. And each one of the teams and each one of the events that happens in here, it'll look like it was built just for them.
Talk about the numbers for us, how much it will hold for basketball, hockey, concerts, things like that, and what it took to put this place together.
The maximum capacity for the building will be about 10,300. For basketball, we hope to get about between 9,300 and 9,500 seats in here. For hockey, we'll get about 8,500 seats in here. And then we can go down as low as 3,500 for a theatrical event. We'll also be doing events with the Fine Arts Center on campus, and they'll be doing theatrical promotions in here.
We use curtains and things like that to make the place look different for each event.
Exactly. That goes back to the flexibility. The way this was designed, we'll be able to do several different things in here, and it'll look tremendous every time we change it.
John, how much are you worried about it not being like the cage, not being as close an environment as the cage was?
Well, the thing that we talked about, and again, are putting seats down to the floor.
and seats in the end zones down to the floor, and that's what happens. Lee, let me ask you a question. Other than our basketball games Thursday and Saturday, what do you have coming in?
Well, it's a three-tiered effect. We start off with the open house on Sunday. Then from there, we go into the grand opening schedule events, which naturally kicks off with the basketball game on the 4th. Then we go into another basketball game on the 6th. We go into Jesus Christ Superstar, Ice Capades, David Copperfield. And basically what we're doing is we're showing off the building. Because it is so flexible, we can do ice events, we can do basketball events, we can do theatrical events. We will, in that first month or so, have a whole category of events that basically shows off all the different dimensions of the building.
What's really neat is, as John was pointing out before, it really doesn't look like there's a bad seat in the house either.
Oh, there really isn't. It's a tremendous place. Again, you know, the university and the state put a tremendous amount of thought and effort into this building, and it's just going to be a fantastic place, not only for people to play in, but also for patrons to come and watch the events in.
Where's your seat, by the way?
Midcourt.
Right next to my wife.
Well, I won't be sitting. I'll be moving often just to make sure that everything is going well in the building. We want to really make this place into a situation that the team is comfortable in here, the teams are comfortable in here, and this really becomes a place that feels very much like home to them, and we'll do everything we can to support them and bring them hopefully to the ultimate and to the Final Four.
Okay, we have a lot more coming up from the Mullins Center, but first, do you remember this former UMass Minuteman?
They shot into the spotlight against Siena in 1991. Last season, they shocked Syracuse in the NCAAs.
Harper Williams puts up the three! Got it!
UMass basketball. It's exciting and fun to watch.
Hi, I'm John Calipari. The UMass Core Club is behind our basketball program every step of the way. If you want to get involved, call the Athletic Development Office at 545-4290. Our team appreciates your support.
Welcome back to the Mullins Center. John and I are standing in the VIP room, which gives you a spectacular view of the arena, bird's eye view for very important people, John.
Well, it's a great building. It's a great view from up here. It gives us a chance to entertain big donors, private business, get people involved in our university. And I think this is a great place to do it.
One of those VIPs is the Chancellor of the University of Massachusetts, Richard O'Brien. Steve Rulio recently had a chance to sit down with the Chancellor and talk about UMass, about basketball, and a few other things.
Good basketball is good for this campus. Good athletics is good for it. And why? For so many different reasons. The alums love it, and it helps them to participate and participate financially, so that's good. And it helps the public in large to recognize us. Being out there and on the media is good for us. We like to have our name mentioned. We like to be a household word. And in turn, that, for kind of crazy reasons, has a direct effect upon undergraduate recruitment. We went up from 3,200 freshmen the year before last to 3,900 this fall. And a big factor in there is just success and being in the public eye and get a sense of enthusiasm and effectiveness. Until 18 months ago, I wasn't involved in the athletics in any way, and my predecessors simply didn't, I don't know, they didn't get it. They really didn't, I think, see that athletics is not just something for a small group of fans, it's something for the whole institution. So I've just deliberately got out in front there and tried to push it because I think it deserves it. It is a real investment, and it produces results both in spirit and in money and in enrollment. But the things we were hearing about 6 months were actually historical. They were from years past, and we've got those cleaned out now, I think. We've reorganized our way of doing things some. I think we're clean now. Then Glenn Wong came in as acting as interim AD and has done a terrific job. He's healed up the wounds and people have got a lot of enthusiasm for him. This last 12 months has seen success in so many different areas. Right. Women's soccer and water polo, all kinds of areas. It's been a terrific year.
Sure has.
And a lot of that is owed to the people who built this over the last 10 years, because these things don't happen just by chance. We're destined to be one of the great state universities of this country. And one of the ways you do that is get the enthusiasm of everybody. And whatever you do really well. Mm-hmm. I mean, to see the first in the House of Representatives and then in the Senate earlier last year, to see them, the standing ovations for the basketball teams and the speeches that were made. All that is the kind of stuff that goes with being a fine university. So we like it. It's good for us in every way, Steve.
Chancellor Richard O'Brien, a big fan of the university, a big fan of your basketball team. Well, I've nicknamed him Coach O'Brien, and he's done an outstanding job here in a lot of areas, but specifically with athletics, he's taking a role that no other chancellor has, and it shows. New building, great programs, and I think it all starts with the point man, and that man was Richard O'Brien. Things are looking bright. It's a bright future for UMass, for the university, for the Minutemen, and it all starts here at the Mullins Center, February the 4th against West Virginia. It's going to be fun. I hope we're as nice as this building. I don't know if we can be, because this is a very, very special place. You have to come out and see it for yourself. The Mullins Center, February 4th, UMass against West Virginia. John, thanks a lot. It was a pleasure. Thanks. We'll see you later.
Nike UMass Basketball with John Calipari has been brought to you by UMass Alumni Association, UMass Court Club, 9X Yellow Pages, Friendly Restaurants, Mass Lottery, Spalding Sports Worldwide, Wally Computer Associates, your New England Ford dealers, and by all Bob stores.
If you're looking for food prepared to your order fast, but don't want to settle for fast food, try Antonio's. For 30 years, they've offered a delicious and diverse menu. From award-winning grinders to pizza, seafood, and salads, Antonio's has it all.
Whether it be lunchtime, dinnertime, or after hours, come in for the variety and quality that you deserve.
And with locations nearby, you'll never be far from great food and quick, friendly service. Give Antonio's a try and see what you've been missing.